Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today we are going to go over some of the top date and time functions in Microsoft Excel.
If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
So here we have a spreadsheet where we have a column for the year, a column for the month, and a column for the day. So this is a great scenario for using the date function. So if I click in D2 and I type equals date with a left parenthesis, I can see that the first argument I'm being prompted for is the year. So let's click on A2 because that's the column where I am storing the year. And then if I type a comma, I will next be prompted for the month. So let's click in B2 because that's where I'm storing my month and type a comma. And then for the day, let's click in C2 and my parenthesis and hit enter. And I can now see that I'm being returned with a date of 7/18/2003. And if I look here, that is exactly what I wanted. So if I click in D2 and see this square right here, on the bottom right-hand corner of my cell, I'm going to double-click that and copy that formula all the way down. And now I can see this is 8/22/2003, this is 8/15/2001, so I am now being returned with a date for each one of these numbers that correspond to year, month, and day. So we can do a similar function, but instead of being the date, we can do time. So on this sheet, I have the hour, the minute, and the second. So in D2, I'm going to type equals time with a left parenthesis. And the first argument I'm being prompted for is the hour. And that is right here in A2. So I'm just going to click on A2, type a comma. And then the next argument I'm being prompted for is the minute, which is in B2. So I'm going to click on B2, type a comma. And the final argument I'm being prompted for is the second, which is right here in C2. So I'm going to click on C2 and hit enter. And I can now see that I'm being returned with an hour of 12, a minute of 0, and a seconds of 0. So if I click on D2 and I see this little square right here in the bottom right hand corner and I double click, I can copy that formula all the way down. So let's just do some spot checks. If I go here, I'm looking for 4:13:17, and that's what I'm being returned with right here. And if you also notice, we do have the AM PM. So if I were to change this hour here, instead of being 12 to a 0 and hit enter, I can see that that time has now been changed to 12 AM. So just keep in mind, 12 AM is 0, and if I type 12 back here, 12 PM is what the number 12 is. So if I have a 16 here, that is going to be 4 p.m. And right here, if I have a 4 here, that's going to be 4 a.m. So anything 12 and over will be p.m. and anything less than 12 is going to be a.m. So for my third date time function, I would like to just show you one that I use often. Just type equals today with a left parenthesis and a right parenthesis and hit enter. And you will be returned with today's date. So if you notice, today's date is just a date. It doesn't include the time. If you would like to also include the time, you can type equals now with a left parenthesis and a right parenthesis and hit enter, and you will be returned with the date as well as the current time. So this one up here is today, and this one in A2 is now because now includes the time.
If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos.
So let's do the reverse of our date function. What if I already have a date, but I want to know the day of the month? If I type equals day with a left parenthesis, I'll be prompted for an argument where it's really looking for a date. It says serial number here, but it means a date. So if I click on this date here and hit enter, I will be returned with the 18th day. And then if I click in my month column and I type equals month with a left parenthesis and click on this date here and hit enter, I will be returned with 7 for the month. And the same thing here, I bet you can guess what it is, equals year with a left parenthesis. Click on a valid date and hit enter, and I am returned with the year. I can also do this same strategy with time functions. So if I click here and I type equals hour with a left parenthesis, and I click on a valid time and hit enter, I will be returned with 12. If I click in C2 and I type equals minute with a left parenthesis, and I click on a valid time and hit enter, I'm being returned with the minute. And if I click in D2 and type equals second with a left parenthesis and click on a valid time, I will be returned with the second. This is 12 p.m., so I'm getting a few zeros, but if I highlight these three cells and I double click on the bottom right-hand corner here, I can copy that formula all the way down. And just doing some spot checks, this says 16, but remember it's 4 p.m. and I do have 42 minutes and I do have 34 seconds. Sometimes I have two different dates and I would like to know how many days are in between those two different dates. This is when I would use a DATEDIF function. So if I click in C2 and I type equals date diff and a left parenthesis, let's click on my first date right here in A2 and then type a comma. And then let's click on my second date right here in B2 and then type a comma. Now there's a final argument here. Do I want this in days or months? Let's say for this example, I would like this in months. So what I would do is I would type a double quote, an M, and another double quote. Close my parentheses and hit enter. And I can see that between the start date and the end date, the difference is 2 months because it's July to September and 9 minus 7 is 2. However, if I click in here and let's just change this M in these double quotes to a D and I hit enter, this is the number of days that are in between July 4th, 2023 and September 30th, 2023. And then you could also change the D up here to a Y and hit enter and get the difference in years. So in this case, there's 0 years because they're both 2023. But say I were to go in here and change this to 7/4/2022 and hit enter, I now have a difference of 1. The next function I would like to show you is one called weekday. Sometimes there is a date and we're not sure what day of the week it is. So there's a function, if I click in B2 and type equals weekday with a left parenthesis and click my date here and hit enter, I am returned with a weekday of 3. You may be asking yourself what a 3 is. 3 corresponds to Tuesday. So the first day of the week is Sunday with the value of 1, a Monday is 2, a Tuesday is 3, all the way up to a Saturday being 7. So you would have to keep that in mind when using the weekday function. And finally, we have a week number function. So what the week number function does is it takes a date and it tells you what week of the year that date is. So obviously the week of January 1st is always going to be the first week of the year. The week that January 8th falls is going to be the second week of the year, and so on. So let's type equals week NUM with a left parenthesis. Click on this date here and hit enter. And I can see that July 4th, 2023 was the 27th week of the year. And if I go back to any calendar application and count them all up, it is in fact the 27th week of the year. We have a few more date and time functions on our blog for this topic. I'll include that link below in the description if you would like to learn more. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below and we'll get back to you. As always, thanks for watching and see you again next time.
If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotion and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.